Hi friends, welcome to today's video. So today we are dealing with a data sufficiency question. So what do you mean by data sufficiency? In data sufficiency questions, one question will be given and then two statements will also be given. By using the two statements, you should be able to find the solution to the problem. So here you need not find out the solution. You just need to analyze which all statements are required to solve the problem. So let's see the first question. The problem is find the two-digit number. The first sentence is the difference between two digits is 5. And the second sentence is the sum of digits is 6 more than their difference. Now what are the options given? We are having options from A to E. Then A is if 1 alone is sufficient but 2 alone is not sufficient. The statement 1 alone, by using statement 1 alone you are able to solve the problem. But by using statement 2 alone, we are not able to solve the problem. Then you have to answer A. Vice versa. If 2 alone is sufficient to solve the problem, but 1 alone is not sufficient, means you have to answer B. If 1 or 2 alone, either by using statement 1 or by using statement 2, you are able to solve the problem, means you have to give C. Then if both 1 and 2 together are not sufficient, you are using both statements 1 and 2. Still you are not able to solve the problem, means you can give D. Then by using the statements 1 and 2, you are able to get the answer, means you can give E. So these are the different options. So let's go to the question. So find the two digit number. The first sentence is the difference between the two digits is 5. So let us take the digits be equal to X and Y. Okay. So we will be getting X minus Y is equal to 5. So this is the equation which we are getting from statement 1. So whatever be the sentence given, you have to convert it into an equation. That is the first step. Whatever be the statement given, convert it into the corresponding equation. So it will be more easy to analyze. So X minus Y is equal to 5. This is the statement you are getting from, or this is the equation you are getting from first statement. So X minus Y is equal to 5. By using this statement, are you able to solve for X and Y? You will not be able to solve. You already know if there are two unknown variables, you must have two equations. Only if you are having two equations, then you will be able to solve for two unknown variables. Only one equation means only one unknown variable should be there. So 5X is equal to 10. In that equation, there is only one unknown variable, X. So you can easily solve by X is equal to 10 divided by 5 is equal to 2. So but in an equation, if there are two unknown variables, you should have two equations, then only you will be able to solve. So by using one alone, you are not able to get the answer to the problem. Now second statement, again we can transform to an equation. The sum of digits is 6 more than their difference. So that is given here. That means X plus Y is equal to X minus Y plus 6. The sum of the digits is 6 more than their difference. Difference is given as X minus Y. And the sum will be given as X plus Y. So X plus Y is equal to X minus Y plus 6. So by using this equation 2 alone, are you able to solve the equation? Are you able to find out a solution to the problem? So here X and X will be getting cancelled. So you will be getting 2Y is equal to 6 and you will be getting Y. So Y you will be obtaining from the second equation, but X we cannot obtain. X we cannot obtain from the second equation alone. The second statement alone is also not sufficient to answer the question. Now let us see whether both 1 and 2. Okay, so both 1 and 2 together is sufficient to answer the question or not. So that is what we have to find out next. So we determine that 1 alone is not sufficient to answer the question. Similarly, 2 alone is not sufficient to answer the question. Now, next our aim is to find out whether both 1 and 2 together are sufficient to answer the question. So, when you are solving this, you will be getting X and Y. Obviously, you will be getting X and Y because you are having two equations. Or you can write here X plus Y is equal to 5 plus 6. So, you will be getting X plus Y is equal to 11. And then using the two equations, X minus Y is equal to 5 and X plus Y is equal to 11. You can easily solve X and Y. You are having two unknowns and you are having two equations. So you will be getting X and Y. Then again a problem exists. What is that problem? You have to find out the two digit number. So this x and y can either be xy or it can be yx. So that we cannot determine by the two options given, because here it is nothing is given like x and y, which is higher, it should come on the units digit or it should come in the tens place. Likewise, no information is given. So we cannot say whether the number is xy or yx. Okay, for your understanding, I'll just solve this. So x minus y is equal to 5 and x plus y is equal to 11. So from that you will be getting x is equal to 8. Okay, 2x is equal to 16. So you will be getting x is equal to 8 and y is equal to 3. So you can either have the number equal to 38 or the number can be 83. But there is no clue as to whether the number is 38 or 83 from the two statements given. One is just like the difference between the two digits is 5, which is applicable for both 38 and 83. Similarly, the second statement is the sum of digits is 6 more than their difference. That is also applicable for both 38 and 83. So you cannot determine whether the number is xy or yx by using the two statements given. So what will be your answer? If both 1 and 2 together are not sufficient to answer the question, you have to give it as D. So D or dog will be your option here. Even if both the statements 1 and 2 together are used, you are not able to answer the question. Now, second question, the options are same. A to B options are given in the same way. The question is, find the ratio between the two digits in the two digit number. You have to find out the ratio between the two digits in the two digit number. The largest digit is 8. Then second question is, the sum of digits in number is 4 times their difference. Okay, so first sentence is, the largest digit is 8. So you understand that one digit is 8. So from that, can you find out the ratio between the two digits? No, you cannot find out the ratio between the two digits. Only the information about one digit is given. There is no information about the second digit. So using the first statement alone, you are not able to solve the problem. Now, what is the second statement? The sum of digits in number is 4 times their difference. So let the digits be x and y. So what is your aim? You have to transform the statement given to an equation. So sum of digits x plus y is 4 times their difference. So 4 into x minus y. X plus y is equal to 4 into x minus y. So this is the second statement. And what you are asked to find out? You are asked to find out x by y. Or you are asked to find out the ratio of the two digits. So can you find out x plus y is equal to 4 into x minus y is given? So will you be able to find out x by y from this equation? Surely you can do. When you are solving this, x plus y is equal to 4 into x minus y, and you can write x terms in one side and y terms in the other side, you will be able to get x by y. So by using this statement 2 alone, you will be able to get the answer to the problem. So what is that option you have to give? You have to give box, or B will be your answer. By using statement 2 alone, you will be able to solve the problem, but one alone is not sufficient. Now, third question, sum of 6 numbers A, B, C, D, E and F is 18,000. Find C. So what is given? So let's first write down what is given. A plus B plus C plus D plus E plus F is equal to 18,000. Now, what is your first statement? Sum of A plus B plus D is equal to 12,000. So by using this, will you be able to find out C? You are having A plus B plus D is equal to 12,000. So you are having A plus B plus D. So 12,000 plus C plus E plus F is equal to 18,000. So by using statement 1 alone, you will not be able to get C. Now let's go to statement 2. What is statement 2? Sum of E and F is equal to 5,000. First you have to see, by using statement 2 alone, are you able to answer the problem. So E plus F is equal to 5,000. So you will be getting A plus B plus C plus D plus 5,000 is equal to 18,000. So by using that statement alone also, you will not be able to solve the problem. Now you have to see whether both 1 and 2 together, when you are using both 1 and 2 together, will you be able to solve the problem. So what you will be getting, you are applying both 1 and 2. A plus B plus D is equal to 12,000 and E plus F is equal to 5,000. So what you will be getting, 12,000 plus 5,000 plus C is equal to 18,000. As simple as that. By using both statement 1 and 2, you will be getting an equation like 12,000 plus 5,000 plus C is equal to 18,000. So you will be getting C by using the two statements together. So what will be your option? Your option will be elephant, or E will be your option. By using 1 and 2 together, you are able to solve the problem. The next question, there are two given numbers P and Q. Is P greater than Q? That is the question. You have to find out whether P is greater than Q. So our first sentence is P is greater than 100. So are you able to answer our question, is P greater than Q, by using the first statement? First statement is given, P is greater than 100. It is not giving any information about Q. So by using statement 1 alone, you will not be able to answer the question. Now what is statement 2? Statement 2 is Q greater than 90. So by using this second statement alone, are you able to answer the question? Q is greater than 90, there is no clue about P. So again, 2 alone is not sufficient to answer the question. Now third part is, you have to see whether these both statements 1 and 2 together, are you able to answer the question. So P greater than 100 and Q greater than 90. So P greater than 100 means it can be any number starting from 101 to infinity. P can be any number. And Q greater than 90 means Q can be any number from 91 to infinity. So even though by using both the statements, we are not able to answer the question. So our option will be dog, or D will be our option. Thank you for watching.